you hear, wait, wait. One thing you must understand is that waiting is not sweet. Yes, it's never a sweet process to go through. But you see, if only you can see eternity, if only you can see the glory that is ahead of you, you will endure anything. You will endure anything. Yes. You will endure anything. Scripture says, he that shall endure to the end is endurance. Is endurance. He that shall endure till the end. Yes. It's going to be a matter of endurance. Yes. Some of the situation you will pray and they will not go. It will be a matter of endurance. Yes. Yes. You will fast over it. It won't go. It will be a matter of endurance. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. We want to wait a little bit. A little longer. We'll pray the Holy Ghost in a moment before we revisit that prayer about our fathers. I will wait until my wings, until I am sure that my wings have grown. And not just grown, they are strong to withstand any storm. Yes. And even when I notice that my wings are grown, I will wait until the day it is time for the storm. Because in that time, I will not be flying, I will only soar. We want to ask the Lord again, equip us with strength for the journey ahead. What is at stake is eternal. It's not a shoe or a car that is at stake. Yes, it's not even marriage that is at stake. It's not your job that is at stake. It's not even your good health that is at stake. What is at stake is eternal. It's your soul. We are not afraid of the darkness that is coming. No. No. We are not afraid of it. In a moment of time, we will ask Jesus for strength. Because a time cometh, even if you desire in your heart to follow the law, the flesh will be weak. Yes. You've read that scriptures. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Yes. A time cometh that men will become weary, even if in their heart they desire to follow Jesus. The strength will no longer be there. They don't have. Oh God. Eat, for the journey is great. For the journey is great. Even if you desire in your heart to follow Jesus. Have you not heard many who say, I want to follow the Lord, but this sin is. That's little to what is coming. Maybe before, to help you pray. The Lord began to tell me a lot of things. In around last year, towards the end. And I saw the need that men would take root, go deep down. This has nothing to do with preaching. No. It has nothing to do with standing on the pulpit. You just go deep down. Because a wind is coming. And the purpose of that wind is that it wants to toss. But men that are rooted, from afar, they will be able to discern. They will be able to discern. And so I began to hear the Lord said to me that pastors and owners of ministries will begin to adjust messages just to fit into what they feel is current, so that they can have crowd. But these are not the days to please men. These are the days to please God. These are not the days to impress anyone. Yes, these are the days to begin to bring the very counsel of God to the people. I saw the high and mighty not caring whether this is a contamination or this is sin. What they care about was that their churches were filled up. That was what they all care about. The days are coming. And if you, some of us, the reason why some of us are the way we are is because we have fathers that will rebuke us and teach us right. If your father begins to walk in error, there is a huge tendency that you will also walk in error. Yes, there is a huge tendency that you will also walk in error. The days of corruption, serious corruption, is upon us. Yes, is upon us. Because men don't want anybody to think they are failing. And their idea of a prosperous ministry is crowd. No, he called us to be faithful. He called us to be faithful. And he that is faithful in little things, what shall be done to him? More will be committed to him. Maybe I should bring this a little. Young man, young lady, there was a point in your life. Nobody knew you. You were laboring in prayers. And you were content with talking to just 2-3 persons. And you were so committed to it. You were committed to it. Suddenly, 4, 5, you were committed. 6, 7. You are committed. 8, 9, 10. You are committed. You were laboring. What matters to you? What mattered to you at that point was that Jesus alone be seen. Suddenly, you are now on billboard. You are now seen on TV. And in your wildest mind, you don't think it is time to come into rest. Yeah. Let me tell you, he that is faithful in little labor, the reward, the compensation for that faithfulness is that he will add more labor to him. Yes, that's how it works in our kingdom. They will add more labor. I'm trying to tell you that why Jesus gave you that visibility is not for fat envelopes. It's so that your knee will go down more. There is need for you to be wasted more. If Jesus gives you a territory, he didn't give you the gold of that territory. He gave you the souls of that territory. What he's saying is that cultivate this land. Labor over it. Labor over it until I am seen. Until I become this, the only one that is held in that territory. This, welcome to our generation, where people think that it's everybody that has gone viral that went viral because they want to get money. No. Some of us, by his mercies, we are going to be spent. That is the aim. Anytime we go out, we come back or not, the aim is that Jesus be exalted. Young ministers like myself, whether music or word, whatever I want you to know that the visibility that Jesus gave you is not so that you come to a realization that it is now time for my envelope to be fat. No. I want you to come to the realization that my labor is now bigger than the way it used to be. In other words, if I used to labor for 12 hours when I used to talk to a few people, now maybe 3 days, whether in prayers or in study of the word, you must enlarge capacity. And this is not so that you come before people and they say, oh, this one is deep. No. You will labor. After we pray for our fathers, we will ask Jesus to give us genuine laborers. Because we have lost some persons to visibility. Yes. We have lost some persons to visibility. I see that even Christians now give gifts and they put it on Facebook. It's a sign you no longer read your Bible. Jesus said, when you want to do alms, he said, do it in secret. You give gifts now, we see it on Facebook. You think I'm talking to you? Yes, I'm talking to you. You cannot bring the name of Jesus to what it is not. There is a way that it is done in this kingdom. And it kabalatamansky. We will stand and watch it and make sure that that pattern is not thwarted. Some of us have the responsibility to make sure that this thing is modeled right and accurately. You do your charity, you take pictures and put online, simply because somebody said, see the worldly people, they are doing this. Where are the pastors? We are not the same. I can't come and tell you what I am doing. My service is not to the public, it's to my master. And where he sees is in secret. That is where he sees. In secret.
I will wait on you.
We have lost some vibrant soldiers to visibility. And we must ask Jesus, bring them back to us and send in more laborers. We need laborers. Yes, we need laborers. I know you know of the scriptures that calls you kings and priests, but this king is the one that will lay down his life for his subject. This king that you have is the one that will lay down his life. You will spend all that you have, and even you will be spent. Wake up! We need laborers. People that are willing to be wasted for this cause, not minding if I die, I die, and if I perish, I perish. What matters is that my master, his name is Jesus. We need laborers. Now we can no longer tell if you are a minister or a model. Logo bigger. you want to go and conquer an industry? My God, I wish I wish I can say a lot of things. I wish I can say a lot of things. We need laborers. 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 I was privileged to go and minister with Reverend Austin in Abraka. And when I got there, my heart, I wept like a child. Every one of us, now we are committed to online ministry. Our campuses are suffering. Our campuses are dying. We need laborers. Young man, the Lord gave you an assignment. Your belly has become your God. We need laborers. Lord, we ask, we cry, send in laborers. Men who no longer care. Laborers. 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 Ugo do go go go. I bet the kobolo to manda. Ambo boko skita kaba. Oh, aye. Hey. Kutoma. Ululululu. Katatias. My God. My God. My God. My God. Send laborers. We know we have a lot of preachers. We know we have teachers, apostles, and prophets. Oh, but send in laborers. Genuine laborers. Laborers. I came by prayer. I will stay in prayer. When to you we leave this world, I will go in prayer. I came by prayer. I will stay in prayer. When to you we leave this world. When I was younger, Uncle Sam, people don't want to be pastors. When I was younger, people, being a servant of God was not something that was enviable. When I was younger, it wasn't. Now, anybody wants to become a pastor because we have turned it to something that is lucrative. When people see us, they no longer see a dead man. They see a man who, oh my God, who is alive in the flesh. Come on, Ziatala. Hey, when I was younger, there is a group I used to know in our church. They call them prayer warrior. Prayer warrior. You see those people? Let anything be wrong with you, and you come into their midst, and you cry and say, see you, this is what is doing me. They will just tell you, just go home, fast for 3 days. And when they tell you that thing, as you are fasting, they will just hold their hands. If they pray, it will happen. But you see now, that ancient pattern must be returned. Yes. It has to return. It has to return. It has to return. Our heritage. The potency of the church. I have heard a lot of people say words like, after God, it is the government. It is a lie. It's a lie. After God, on in heaven is the church on earth. Because we have lost our place, we now feel that after God is the government. No. We will see the days where the church still rule. Can we first of all begin to ask that Jesus will preserve our fathers? If you have genuine fathers, for this cause I came, for this cause I was born. Ante bongolo komandala. If you have genuine fathers, ask that the Lord will preserve them to the end. They have endured this long, but the Lord give them grace that they will endure to the end. Give them grace. Give them grace. Pastor John Onekele. Oh, the Lord preserve you. That is Sunday Oguche. The Lord preserve you. That is Amana. The Lord preserve you. Dr. Asana Chimugu. The Lord preserve you. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Apostle Aaron Melsai. The Lord preserve you. Oh my God. Oh my God. Die. Evangelist Solomon Salami. The Lord preserve you. Apostle Gideon Odoma. Abebebene. The truth in your mouth will not be contaminated. Oh, Reverend Austin Oporie. The Lord preserve you. Abaratakasia. Abebebebo. Edutukuaya. The Lord preserve you. Lawrence Oyo. The Lord preserve you. Abaratakaskianta. Amanda Fada. Abebebo Ruatas. Hey, Tony Ritchie. The Lord preserve you. Abenia. Sovenenetele. Abrastai. Bara.
If you know their names, call them.
Can you pray, young man? Can you pray? Can you pray? Can you pray? Can you pray? Apostle Oliver Uzochukwu, the Lord preserve you. Yes, you will not go out of strength. The Lord preserve you. Our fathers in Igala land, the Lord preserve them. We use them as a point of contact. The Lord preserve them. The Lord preserve them. The Lord preserve. The Lord preserve. The Lord preserve. The Lord preserve. I Abrastika. All the names that we have called, we use them as a point of contact to men of God who are genuine all over the world. The Lord preserve you. Can you pray? Can you pray?